Where are the cast of the Sandlot Now? Number 9. Tom Guiry. As the lead character of 1993's The Sandlot, Tom Guiry played the role of Scotty Smalls. This iconic film chronicles Scotty's adventures in the summer of 1962 when his family moves to the San Fernando Valley. As the new kid in the neighborhood, Smalls tries desperately to fit in with a group of misfits who pass the time by playing pickup baseball games in a vacant lot known as The Sandlot. Go figure. From learning to play baseball, stealing his stepfather's signed Babe Ruth ball, and battling the Beast, Scotty was the catalyst for a series of boyhood misadventures in this classic film. Guiry was 12 years old at the time of the film, which was his acting debut. However, like many child stars, it was arguably the peak of his acting career, though he's maintained a pretty steady presence on the screen. None of his featured work has quite reached the popularity of The Sandlot. However, he's appeared in some critically acclaimed films such as Black Hawk Down, Mystic River, and The Revenant. In 2013, at an airport in Houston, Guiry did get on the wrong side of the law a bit. He was arrested when he apparently headbutted a police officer. He lashed out when he was told he was too drunk to board a flight. Obviously, he didn't take this news well, and he ended up in jail for a bit. In 2018, he took part in the 25th anniversary of The Sandlot alongside his castmates. Guiry is also scheduled to appear in a 2018 film, Roe vs. Wade. Who's your favorite member of The Sandlot? Let us know in the comments. Number 8. Mike Vitar. Playing the role of Benny the Jet Rodriguez in The Sandlot, Mike Vitar played the character who's destined to make it to the major leagues. Benny becomes a famous Major League Baseball player, while Scotty Smalls becomes a sportscaster. Vitar began acting at age 12 when a casting agent spotted him at a school carnival. That seems like an interesting way to find kid actors, but that's neither here nor there. After his breakout in The Sandlot, Vitar kept the whole sports prodigy thing going when he played Louis Mendoza in D2 and D3 in the Mighty Ducks franchise. However, he's given up acting since 1997. He went on to become a firefighter, and since 2002, he's been a member of the Los Angeles Fire Department. Vitar was noticeably absent from all of the 25-year reunion festivities for reasons that are unclear, but it's probably a sign that he's ready to move on from a part of his past 25 years ago. If you're enjoying learning about cast members from The Sandlot, be sure to hit that subscribe button, and also hit the notification bell so you don't miss any videos. Number 7. Patrick Renna. You're killing me, Smalls. That's the famous catchphrase from Hamilton, or Ham Porter. It's easily the most memorable line from the film. The stocky catcher, played by Patrick Renna, was generally depicted as a talented ballplayer and quick-witted kid. He's always the one engaging in a war of words with the other kids on a competing team. In the closing monologue, the audience learns that Ham becomes a professional wrestler, the Great Hambino. An homage to his childhood nickname and Babe Ruth as well. Renna's acting breakout in The Sandlot catapulted what's been a long and mostly successful career. While he's never been, say, an Academy Award winner, Renna's steady presence on the screen has made him one of the more successful cast members from the film. Soon after The Sandlot, he starred in the 1995 film The Big Green, which also featured a group of misfit kids trying to play a sport. Except this time it was soccer. With recurring roles in hit shows like Boston Legal and The X-Files, and guest star appearances in ER, The Closer, CSI, and GLOW, just to name a few, Renna has been busy in the 25 years since The Sandlot. He's also an accomplished voice actor, having used his voice in a variety of commercials and video games. Renna is married with a kid, and also practices Scientology, so yeah, there's that. No, we're not going to touch the whole Scientology thing in this video. Number 6. Brandon Adams. If you grew up in the 90s, then chances are you know Brandon Adams. Even though he was only a secondary character playing the role of Kenny DeNunez in The Sandlot, he's been in plenty of other roles on TV. Kenny was the gang's talented pitcher, and he helped his team beat the Tigers in the movie. Later in the film, we learn that he played in the minor leagues, making it all the way to AAA ball, but he never played in the majors. As far as Adams himself goes, the 90s was a great decade for him. Soon after The Sandlot, he joined some of his other castmates in D2, The Mighty Ducks. After that, he appeared in many of the 90s staple sitcoms such as Martin, Boy Meets World, Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, Moesha, Sister Sister, and The Burning Zone. After 2001, when he appeared in MacArthur Park, Adams wanted some time off from acting. He enlisted in film school under the name B. Lee and released a hip-hop mixtape called B. Lee HD. Adams says these days, he still runs into women who admit to having a crush on him in their younger days. Milk it for all it is worth is what we say. Number 5. Grant Gelt. Grant Gelt played the role of Bertram Weeks, who famously quoted, "got really into the 60s and no one ever heard from him again." A glasses-wearing kid who was both nice and good at playing baseball, Bertram wasn't one of the most memorable characters, but he was part of the gang all the same. After The Sandlot, Gelt kept appearing in acting roles during the 90s and appeared in hit sitcoms such as Saved by the Bell and Boy Meets World. He also actually was in Revenge of the Nerds before the success of The Sandlot. His last acting credit, kind of ironic, was in 1999 in a TV movie called The 60s. Gelt eventually switched to music and has worked in a number of positions in the industry. For example, he managed the rock band Black Rebel Motorcycle Club. Since 2016, Gelt has been the senior director of business development at Full Screen Media, a company based in Nashville, Tennessee. He helps bands, artists, and creators engage with their fans and market their work. He's worked with bands such as the Red Hot Chili Peppers, Bon Iver, and Eric Church. Number 4. Marty York. Marty York played the role of Alan Yeah Yeah McLennan, and just as the character's nickname would suggest, much of his dialogue began with "yeah yeah." Over the next several years, York played a variety of roles in shows such as Boy Meets World, Saved by the Bell, Duckman, and Hey Arnold. After taking a pretty long break from acting, York recently resurfaced in a few indie films. He also took part in many of the 25-year reunion activities in 2018, appearing in Major League Baseball stadiums all across the country. York does have a blemish on his record, however. In 2009, York was arrested after admitting to backhanding his girlfriend. York claimed it was in self-defense and ultimately had no charges pressed against him. Number 3. Victor DiMattia. Playing the role of Timmy Timmons was Victor DiMattia. Timmy, like all the other characters in the film, loved baseball and feared the beast. Known for his love of architecture, he was essential to building and rebuilding the treehouse the boys often played in. In the closing monologue, it's revealed that Timmy and his brother Tommy became architects who became multimillionaires when they invented mini malls. At the time of The Sandlot, DiMattia was an established child actor. In 1987, he starred in a Dennis the Menace movie, and he also appeared in Married with Children, Growing Pains, Days of Our Lives, and Turner and Hooch. After The Sandlot, DiMattia appeared in a TV movie called Children of the Dark. Then his voice was used for some of the Adventures in Odyssey radio dramas, a Christian-based series for kids. After 1995, DiMattia took a long break from acting. He finally reappeared in 2018 in a film called Get Married or Die. In the 23 years between his movie appearances, DiMattia did do some other work in the industry, such as writing and directing a short film called Buck McMahon in 2013. DiMattia also hosts his own podcast called Vic in a Box, along with his friend Steve. The show touches on a variety of subjects ranging from pop culture to superheroes and more. And, as you would expect, over the summer of 2018, he hosted many of the guys from The Sandlot on his podcast. Number 2. Chauncey Lepardi. Chauncey Lepardi has been appearing in film and on TV since he was 5 years old. With over 3.5 decades of film credits to his name, the biggest role to date is arguably the role of Michael Squints Pelodorus in The Sandlot. Of all the smart-ass kids in the film, Squints probably stands alone. He's shown to be a pretty intelligent kid, but he's responsible for spreading the myth about the beast. Squints also masterminded the plot to hit on lifeguard Wendy Peppercorn at the kid's local pool. Not being able to swim, he lunged into the deep end only to be saved by Wendy. When she began to resuscitate him by CPR, he begins kissing her. Understandably repulsed, she kicks out Squints and the rest of the gang from the pool. At the end of the movie, adult Smalls reveals that Squints grew up and married Wendy, had 9 kids, and owned a drugstore. In the years since playing Squints, Lepardi has appeared in plenty of other films and series. He's appeared on shows such as Walker, Texas Rangers, CSI, Freaks and Geeks, and Boy Meets World. He also reprised the role of Squints in The Sandlot Heading Home in 2007. Number 1. Shane Obedzinski. The role of Tommy Repeat Timmons was played by Shane Obedzinski. For the most part, Obedzinski's acting career is pretty much limited to his appearance in The Sandlot, where he played Timmy's little brother. Like his fictional brother, Timmy loved architecture and baseball, and later became a millionaire when he helped invent mini malls. After a few years of playing in commercials and movies, Obedzinski moved on to doing other things. In 2013, he was featured in the Tampa Bay Times when he opened his own pizzeria in Brandon, Florida. Alongside his partner Charlie Jonathan, Obudzinski's engaged in a number of restaurant ventures. According to those who know him, Obudzinski still receives fan mail and is by all accounts very generous with his time with fans. While his acting has pretty much become non-existent, he has mentioned that he'd like to get back into acting at some point. Here's what's next.